So today's talk is going to be a mixture of audio, AR, wearables, and AI. And the reason I have AI kind of small there is because these days it's a lot easier to do AI and build apps because there's a lot of frameworks and libraries out there, and I'll get into that in a moment. So I'm Dan Zeitman. I'm a senior developer advocate with Bose. The gray beard might indicate I've been around for a while. I've been doing software development for about 35 years and had a startup in about a decade ago when the iPhone was first coming out, and started getting into developer advocacy and just really enjoyed it because it's a role where you get to help developers build really cool things. That's my contact info. Feel free to reach out afterwards. So the goals of today's talk is to explore a little about what we're doing at Bose in audio augmented reality area, spatial audio and so forth, and talk about sensor-driven experiences. And then I'm going to talk a little about how you can actually leverage the platform and to be able to do some really fun, interesting things. But to start it off, I thought it would be really cool. Give me one sec. That would be really cool to kind of show you something kind of fun. We just released this. This is the radar app, and let me make sure it's on the right screen. Not seeing it there. So, one second. Let me do the mirror trick. All right. So this is my iPhone here, and I'm going to connect it up with the frames. Now this is our frames. Inside here, it's a pair of speakers. But more importantly is an IMU. So there's an accelerometer, a magnetometer, and a gyroscope. And by having that, it allows you to do some really fun, interesting things. Can you pull up the audio on the... Okay, one second. So as I rotate this, you're getting the sound. If you were hearing this in stereo headphones, you get a spatialized, immersive experience. So the idea here is the ability to create experiences that are much more immersive. And in order to do that, we've been able to put sensors in our headphone products. So, real quickly, Bose wearables, what are they? It's pretty much anything you can wear. So right now we have a series of products from the sunglasses to our latest headphones that have these IMUs in there. And it takes we want to talk about what is Bose AR and what it is not. So it's not this, right? It's not putting something in front of your face. In fact, with this open ear device, this means you truly get a blend of the real environment plus whatever we augment with audio. And I started off talking about spatial audio because that's a huge component of what makes this really interesting. It's also not being focused on your screen or your device. So simply put, it's about augmenting your world with sound. It's an audio-first approach. And these simple sensors capture your motion, and they enable that sort of experience. Together with an app. You need an app to do that. So what sort of experiences are we talking about? Has anybody seen the announcement? We've just tied together an opportunity with Disney and Lucasfilm. Next month, you'll be able to step into the Star Wars saga and be able to experience it in a very different way. There's been a lot of Star Wars AR, VR apps out there, but this is the first time that it's completely audio-focused. I've been the lead on the enablement for this project, and it's been pretty exciting to work with the folks over at Lucasfilm to bring together this experience. So we're in entertainment. We're in travel. If you can imagine that once you have a device heading, you have your GPS for your location, but getting the heading of what the person is looking at means you can use the sensors on here to enable experiences such as I'm looking at a particular building and be able to pull up the Yelp review and so forth. In activity, we have Golf Shot and other programs like that, fitness apps. You can use this to track the user motion, so if I'm walking or running, and I'm gonna talk about how that is happened shortly. And of course in music, you heard the Lion King song here, but we're doing a lot in the music area, and there'll be much more in the years to come. In games, of course. We just released this. This is Bose Arcade in conjunction with Playcrafting. There's dozens of really fun casual games that allow you to engage with Bose AR. And so these tend to be audio-first games, but they use gestures and they use a lot of the different movements. So the platform is comprised of three bits: products, toolkit, and the creators like yourselves. On the product side, as I mentioned before, we had the frames. We were at South By 2 years ago with a printed prototype. It went to market over the following 9 months. And it's been doing really well. It's really interesting because when you hand this to someone, the first thing they say is, it's really light, that's cool. And then they put it on, they hear the sound, and they're really surprised because the quality of this matches up to our brand that we've been doing. the QC35s. Last year, in November, we released a new updated version of that product, and we included the IMU in that. And then in March, we just slowly updated the firmware on that. So if you have a QC35 number two, within the last year or so, you probably already have Bose AR enabled. And then our latest headphone in the NC700. This one has a capacitive touch control on the side. There's no, you see very few buttons on there, and that's kind of a new innovation as well. And that also has the sensors. And then last week, we put on sale for the first time the Star Wars edition and sold those for a pre-order. So that means there's about 1 million devices out there. With 1 million devices, we have one of the largest installed base of consumer-facing AR products. And that's a huge thing to remember. Consumers buy our products because they love the sound, but the reality is there's a huge base out there. And it's a great opportunity for developers like yourself. I mentioned we had tools. We have two paths for this. The one path is called the Creator Tool, and this is meant for folks that are really more creative and less technical, and it's a browser-based solution. And the other is through our Bose AR SDKs. And let me. Give you a quick preview of that. So the SDKs is available at developer.bose.com. There's a bunch of downloads, and essentially you're able to get an SDK for iOS, Android, or a Unity plugin. And on the Creator Tools side, my apologies. The way it simply works is you can create a team, and then you can build out an experience. I was in London last week, and we may have connectivity. There we go. And basically, the way that the tool works is you can create a scene, you can give it a little description, you can then add a bass audio track, select a track, and then set it. And you can either set it as a single heading or two or three headings. And when you do that, then the sound is arranged around the user. And the other thing you can do is set it to a GPS location. So that's the Creator Tool. It ends up creating the same experience that you saw the Disney example pushed to the Radar app. With the Bose AR SDK, as I mentioned, it's all about building mobile apps that are connected to the headphones. And at the end of the day, it's about raw data. So I wanted to show you the raw data itself is pretty straightforward. We're gonna open up a new example, which is our data recorder. I'm connected to my frame, so we see it there. And with this, I'll record some walking. I'm gonna hit record and start walking. As I'm walking around, I'm gathering the data. And it'll crash it. Try that again. So I'm walking around. Does he just get this interactive? I don't know. So it's capturing all the accelerometer data there. And then I'll go ahead and share it. Let's look at it. So here I just generated a CSV. And we got the pitch, the roll, the yaw, and then we get values for X, Y, Z. Kind of interesting, but in a spreadsheet, it's really hard to visualize what's going on, right? So I created a little Jupyter notebook here so we can visualize the data. And so it's pretty simple. I'm just reading in the data here. I'm reading in the data. I'm separating out the accelerometer and the gyroscopic information. And there I'm able to visualize in just a few moments what's coming off of the device. From there, what do you do? Well, there's a bunch of open source projects out there that deal with human activity recording and human activity recognition. Lots of interesting stuff. Most of them are designed for the smartphone that's in your pocket, but with a little tweaking, it's possible to take the same data and turn around and build yourself a model and then push it into Core ML and do that. You could do all that, but there is a kind of an interesting extra simple way you can do it. I mentioned before on our website at developer.bose.com, we also have some extra libraries available, and one of them is a gesture library. So this is probably the quickest, simplest way for you to get into it, and you just simply go and download and in our AR libraries there's two of them available in the first, and you just download it, and then what that'll enable you to do is build a very simple iOS app for it. And in this case, there you go. It's as simple as creating a few lines of code to basically test for that. So let's look at that. So look left, look right, nod, double tap. Head nod, So pretty straightforward. You don't have to go out and build your whole thing. We've kind of made it a little simpler for you. So the standard gestures that the SDK already understand is double tap, nod and shake, and then various movements are coming across. So I mentioned before, we have an accelerometer, a gyroscope, and a magnetometer. And across the board, we're supporting this in all three SDKs. The Unity SDK rides on top of the iOS or Android. And as I mentioned, we had a gesture library. We also have a spatial audio library that enables you to do the same sort of spatialized panning without having to do a lot of heavy-duty coding. And that makes it a little easier. So so far we've looked at the spatial audio, the creator tool. The other way that folks are using Bose AR with AI is with the voice commands. And out of the box, it works really well because there's a microphone on the device as well, on this one as well as on the headsets. And it's pretty straightforward to be able to just enable that. So, next steps. You can learn more about Bose AR at developer.bose.com. On our GitHub under Bose Devs, we have lots of interesting projects that you can download and play around with. And I think that's about it for this. Do we have questions?